Hello and welcome to the second in this series of videos in which we provide an introduction to implementing your own AI-based image processing with the all-in-one solution IDS NXT Ocean. In the previous video, we saw how to acquire our image data from the IDS NXT cameras to build our data set. And in this video, we will see how to upload the images to our NXT Lighthouse web-based AI training service and apply labels and annotations to the images for both the classification and object detection tasks. Now, NXT Lighthouse is a cloud-based software solution that enables users to manage training images for AI-based image processing tasks and to create individual neural networks. We will start by opening NXT Lighthouse in our browser and logging in. Now, the project creation process will be covered in the next video, so for now, let's open the dataset section where we can add new image data for training and can see any existing datasets. So to create new dataset, click on the large plus icon. We can now enter a free text title for the dataset. In this case, we will enter nuts, along with an optional description, walnuts, cashew, and almonds, and add a thumbnail image to help identify the dataset for future use. Next, we need to click on the Image Data tab where we can add the images acquired in the previous tutorial to our dataset. There is the possibility to add separate images, which can be useful for adding individual images later, or complete folders, which is the most convenient way to create a new dataset, and it's the method we will use now. We click Add Folders and then click Add on the resulting dialog and navigate to the folder on the PC that contains the images. Here we can add a single folder if dealing with a single class, or a folder with subfolders if dealing with multiple classes. Then click Upload. If your browser prompts you to, click Upload on the browser message box. We then see a preview of the images and possibly a message about any files that could not be uploaded, most likely because the file does not contain image data, for example, the JSON files that were created with each image. We can also now take advantage of a very quick and easy way to add labels to the images if building a dataset for classification. From the drop-down menu, we can choose to apply labels based on the subfolder name, the main folder, multi-labels, or no labels. A preview of the associated label is shown against each image to explain what each of those means. Here we just need the subfolder names. And having chosen the appropriate labeling, click Upload to complete the process. And we see the dialog showing the uploading progress, and ultimately the images are shown in our image data section. We can now preview the image data statistics and see the number of images in each class. So we can check the balance, and with the graphical donut, we can see any images that are not yet annotated. This statistics interface also provides the convenience of being able to click on any of the labels and immediately filter the images to just those with that specific label. So we can easily find any images that have not yet been labeled or look at a particular image class to check the content. For the purpose of classification, that's all of the labeling we need to do, but for object detection, we need to add labels to specific regions in the image. Now, in some cases, you can use the same data sets for classification and for object detection, but for convenience here, we've used a different data set for the object detection, and we'll jump to that now for this example. The next step then is to create the bounding box annotation, which will be used to draw around each of the objects in the images, in our case, the nuts. So by clicking on the first image in the dataset, we see the full image and a new toolbar on the right for annotations. Here we can add a label for the complete image if required, but now we'll expand the boxes section and choose a color and give the box a name to reflect the object class, and click the Add button to the right-hand side. This box is now available as a template for the object detection annotation process. We then proceed to draw boxes around each instance of the class in the image, and when all of the objects in the image are annotated, click Save, and Next to proceed to the next image. And if dealing with multiple classes, we can add subsequent boxes with different colors and labels. Let's have a look now at some of the features in NXT Lighthouse which can help accelerate or simplify the annotation process. So in applications where the position of the objects or the number and mix of objects is repeated in subsequent images, and there's reasonable uniformity in the position, under actions we can choose to load the previous set of bounding boxes from the last image and then make any minor positional adjustments to match the new image. Or we can even create a number of fixed layouts for specific scenarios, which can greatly accelerate the labeling process in situations where the objects are consistently positioned in the training images. For example, maybe electronic devices and checking for specific components, or looking at variety packs of chocolates or of biscuits. Simply select all the appropriate boxes in the scene, enter a name for the layout, and then click the Add button. And this layout and any other layouts created are then available with a single click. And finally, in this section, we can remove specific bounding boxes if necessary by clicking on the Instances tab. When you click on a bounding box label in the list, the associated bounding box in the image will be highlighted and you can click the Delete button to remove it. Underneath the Annotate button on the right is the Info button, and this provides specific image information and provides the possibility to download that image or delete the image from the dataset. So now back with the annotation process, we can just finish up by putting our bounding boxes onto our last few images and last few objects. And once completed, we see a new set of statistics on the right showing the number of images in the dataset and the number of instances of an object or the utilization. And just to complete this section, the last tab on the display, Annotations, provides an overview of all of the labels, box names, and layouts associated with this dataset, allowing the user to edit these as required. Now that we have completed the labeling and annotation process for our classification and object detection, in the next video we will move on to creating projects for these two use cases and the all-important step of training and building our neural networks. Thanks for watching.